much, Larry. We are here on a beautiful afternoon for football. Today, we're set for a good AFC matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And we say hi again, everybody. Brandon Gaudin here as we count down the kickoff. I turn to my partner, that's Charles. Matchup between the Indianapolis Colts and the Pittsburgh Steelers. And the Buffet Boys, the O-line, hopefully they're ready today.
Listen, you gotta beat them first. But if you do, you usually get a great product out on the field. And when they play
five. Uh-oh, Charles, now you get to talk about your old spot, the secondary. Very key here in this one.
Yeah, you have to cut me off because, you know, I'll talk about them all game long. Love to see those guys match up and challenge the best wide receivers.
As we get a look at the defensive starters, the secondary, they're certainly going to need to be on their toes in this one.
And you know me really well. Where do I start analyzing a game? From the secondary. And these guys have to be on point today. They're facing a high-powered attack.
And when this offense is clicking on all cylinders, the running back is in sync as well.
The focal point. Runs, catches, blocks, sets a tone for the offense.
They'll give it to him right up the gut. And he will have a first down as they get him to the ground at the 37.
The 45. outside handoff to the right side.
Big play for him, but don't forget about the guys you always tell me on the backside sealing off.
When they talk about cutoff blocks, making sure no one can leak from the backside, they can run a play down.
And nobody leaked. Big play. And he'll give it here to his running back. Got an empty juke there.
Not much fun for a guy trying to tackle it.
Touchdown, Indianapolis. A great play there. 51 yards. And the defense caught napping a little bit.
The concentration level may not have been there. I agree with you on that one, because those types of plays, when they result like that, they're almost like big bolts of lightning, aren't they? Whoosh, and off he goes. With the offensive coordinator and the head coach.
Now a handoff here to his running back. And oh, he spins past him and into space. And he's finally taken down, but not before getting across midfield and across the 45-yard line.
Now that's a big
hand analysis from our first half of play. And he's going to go down. They get to him back at the 40. He'll go in the books as a 7-yard loss on the sack. And it's the
Steelers on offense early in the first. Here we get a quick pass and completion, and he'll end up picking up 33 yards on the play. Steelers now lead on the drive. The quick pass and completion is made, and he caps off the 7-play drive with a score. That takes him near the end of one. The pass is completed into tight coverage, and this 5-play drive goes for a touchdown. A brand new headset. First and 10, he'll break free of the pack, and he'll run it in from 52 yards out. They're now on top by 4. They'll line up right at the 22-yard line. He'll take the scrum to right edge. He'll pick up more than 30 yards on the play. But they go on to miss the field goal.
They'll run it now out of the gun. They juked him, and they get him down, but not before he takes it across the 40-yard line. A nice pickup.
But that's the desired outcome coming out of here in the second half, of being able to run the football and establish.
Finding time. Pressure comes, and the Steelers take him down. It'll be a loss of 7 on the sack, and it brings up second.
And sometimes triple team. How about him working his way back and putting the big guy on the ground? How about that? Defensive coordinator perfectly in sync, dials up a blitz, and the man in the middle, he's the one who gets home.
Big Mike.
Big Mike.
They'll come out throwing here on first down. Firing quickly here, and that's complete. And he's going to get this one across the 30-yard line. A nice pickup there of 11 yards, and it'll move the sticks.
When you see zone defense, and you know you've got a drag route on as your primary call, you've got to be really careful as a passer about
to drop the throw. Nowhere to escape, and he goes down. The defense rising to the challenge and setting him back on the sand. And it's never going to take care of this part of the field down near the red zone.
Not at all, because you're already pretty much assured of a field goal. If you take a big sack, it could push you out of range, and that's why defenses get a little more aggressive in this situation. They're almost conceding the 3 points. They want to push you back and try to take
back to throw here. Finding a safety valve here. That's complete. And they'll bring him down at the 13-yard line. It's a pickup of 12, and that'll set up a third down.
Another impressive run. If question has to be asked. How do you slow these guys down running the football? I think
they'll look to throw. And he'll get into the end zone. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Their big tight end, a 2 yard.
Necessarily the tight ends of old. They're the...
He certainly got a bunch for Colts.
Back to the knee, he'll just
throw again.
Here's my question to you.
He's got his man in stride.
People
are
interested in
a gain of 13 and also a first down.
I think should be the nominee for the Democratic Party.
And then I've been going back and forth. I've worked with him right from the field for 5 years in Georgia. And until you understand that Trump leads a political cult, the Democrats are going to make poor decisions.
And they'll go ground game here with a tailback. And he gets it inside the 10 to the 9. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up first to go.
Talk about good down and distance allowing offenses to expand their playbook. Well, second and two, that means your playbook's wide open. You can run just
to have a first down. Here's a play fake as they set up to throw. And he's in. Touchdown, Steelers. Their dangerous wide receiver. A 7 yard touchdown grab. And the Steelers lead here in the fourth quarter. Sixth lead change of the game.
Are we back on the playground on the seesaw battle?
Seesaw battle, yeah.
Up and down. What a game we've watched here.
It's been fun. They'll look to throw. He's going to float this one deep right side. Well, this is taken in. It's complete. Touchdown, Indianapolis. A big play there. His second touchdown of the afternoon. And the Colts
lead.
And now they'll be looking to their defense to preserve that lead. Defensive units. Putting in more two-point period sessions in practice defensively, do you do the same?
Absolutely, you have to, because you never know how aggressive these offenses
are. Get out of bounds, stop the clock.
And I have to criticize defense here, because you know the situation. You want to keep
it to throw. Now they set up the screen, that's complete. And he's going to get this inside the 30. They'll get 17. They'll look to throw. Touchdown, Steelers. Their big tight end from 8 yards out. And the Steelers have taken the lead here in the fourth quarter. Such an art to dot the I, just get the feet in right there against the line before going out of bounds.
Such an incredibly graceful, athletic play. But work on that to make sure that they learn how to train their feet to get down in bounds.
It's just interesting.
They'll look to throw. And he's going to go down. Can't get rid of it. So a sack.
And so people are going to join in with your tax people. So it's important to have these people. You don't have to get in there.
Out of the gun. They'll look to throw. Finding time. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Got a man, it's caught at the 6 yard line. Touchdown, Indianapolis. Their dangerous wide receivers have taken the lead here. The be explosive, and he's ultra explosive there on the fly route.
And you know how many times we've talked to coaches and we've had to quote it back to us. Well, you know something? When you execute really well, it doesn't matter if they know it's
back to throw now on second and 10. Surveying the field. He's gonna let it fly. And oh, a crusher there as it's intercepted. A great read and it's picked off. And they will set up shop. Wanted to close your eyes because of all the points that were being put on the scoreboard. Your defensive guy, but it was a fun little track meet, wasn't it?
It was, and you know the people really enjoyed this game. They're the ones that like going to batting practice in the major league, that sort of deal. That's right up their alley with what we saw in this one.
So that'll just about do it for Charles Davis. I'm Brandon Gordon. You've been watching the NFL on EA Sports. For more, log on to EASports.com. With that, we sign off.